प्रणाम कार्तिकेय जी, टुडे इज अ ग्रेट डे एंड बिकॉज ऑफ ब्रह्मर्षि पितामह पत्री जी वी मेट हियर. प्रणाम टू गुरु जी ऑल्सो. टुडे इज अ ग्रेट मोमेंट इन द पीएसएस एंड हिस्टरी. इट विल बी रिटन इन द गोल्डन वर्ड्स. वी हैव टू हैव कार्तिकेय जी हियर टू गिव एनलाइटेंड मैसेज फॉर ऑल आवर व्यूअर्स एंड पिरामिड मास्टर्स. Welcome to your session, sir. As a IPS cadre personality, you have held various positions like Director of CBI, Special Director General of Human Rights Commission, Director General of CRPF. Like that, your embassy of Moscow and Australia, you held several posts. You are a spiritual Jain and a spiritual scientist. In this connection, we are very much eager to know much about your professional career and how with your professional career itself demands you have held various positions as Director CBI and Director General of CRPF, Special Director General of Human Rights Commission, Embassy of Moscow, Australia, and various top-rank positions you have held in materialistic life. Your profession itself demands toughness in dealing with the cases. But how could you able to come to the spirituality and how it helped in dealing with the cases and tell your spiritual journey to our viewers? Please, sir.
Yes, Mr. Suresh.
Sir.
Mr. Suresh Babu, Dr. Thangavelu.
Yeah.
And Sai Krishna, Anuragi. Namaskar.
Namaskar.
Namaskar, my dear, to all of you.
Namaskar.
Great masters and meditators of the global PSSM movement. Yeah. Namaste, namaskaram undi.
Namaste, namaste, namaskaram.
Vanakkam.
Vanakkam,
I compliment you for organizing this digital dhyana, swadhyaya, yogam or yagam, whatever it is. Mm. Is it yogam or yagam?
Yogam.
Yogam.
Yeah. Mm.
Yes. Thank you. Traditionally,
sir.
Yes, you are. The theme is spirituality, soul science, and enlightenment. The topic for the evening.
Yes.
Traditionally, spirituality refers to a religious process of reformation, which aims to recover the original shape of man, oriented at the image of God, as exemplified by the founders and sacred texts of the religions around the world. We are a community of awakening souls. We share information and articles in hopes to spread the knowledge of spiritual science. Enlightenment is the full comprehension of a situation. There are so many definitions. Enlightenment is coming out of darkness of thoughts and beliefs and into the light and the peace of the soul. The desire for enlightenment is planted deep within every soul. The entire ocean of humanity is moving towards higher levels of consciousness, whether we are aware of it or not. It is because evolution is a natural process of development, from less knowledge to more knowledge, from less power to more power, from less love to unbounded love. The human nervous system is the most highly developed one of all the billions of creations. Spiritual science is the study of the spirit, or also known by its name, the spark of God's light within. If we can connect with the spark of God's light within us, then the spiritual enlightenment becomes possible. Consciousness is always awake and enlightened. But the amount of awakeness or aware consciousness that is present in any moment can vary. The difference in the amount of awakeness or enlightened consciousness that different people experience or that one person experiences at different times, but still suggests that the potential for full awareness or becoming aware is very much there in each one of us. There can be small awakenings and bigger awakenings. Spirituality, through breath energy we understand, is the science of meditation. Dhyana Shastra, and through Dhyana Shastra alone, we understand the science of the soul, or Atma Shastra. I think that is the simplest form. To reach soul enlightenment, one has to go through a few major steps on the spiritual journey. For example, through purifying the soul, heart, the mind, and the body. An enlightened being must have a pure soul, heart, mind, and body. Spiritual enlightenment is the birthright of every human being, and it should be one's goal to achieve it in our lifetime only. When you get true enlightenment, you experience the awareness of separation from your mind, speech, body, and action. So this light of the soul guides us through our life, and this is nothing but your soul. This results in peace and permanent happiness in our life, and it also opens the door to the ultimate liberation for us. The spiritual enlightenment is a shift in awareness where we encounter the non-dual nature of reality and achieve perfect harmony with the world around us. There is no definitive path to spiritual enlightenment. Some achieve it through meditation, some by fasting, some by devotion, and others by occult means also. Spiritual enlightenment is the fundamental goal of most spiritual practices that we undertake. Enlightenment marks the culmination point of our practice. We feel unity of soul with everything. All the mental and physical engagements are left aside. Spiritual enlightenment is the possession of highly evolved souls. It is a privilege. It may be waking up to that reality of oneness. Spiritual traditions and sciences, long at odds, are moving towards a new paradigm of understanding the universe that we are an integral part of. Quantum science, quantum physics in particular, is helping us to discover that all things are truly connected in fundamental ways. They're all but vibrations and energy only. The process of our evolution, as well as that of the world and all the people in it, is that of purification. State of spiritual enlightenment occurs naturally when we deepen in our sadhanas or spiritual practices, and we live consistent with it. A constant focus towards the unlimited sources of love, consciousness, and power creates a more enlightened, more empowered, and more loving state of being in each one of us. When we have raised our vibration enough, our mind will relax and see the blessing in everything around us. So the spiritual wisdom of different teachings and traditions and religions encourages millions of people to be mindful of their thoughts and actions, to develop a deeper awareness, remain calm facing all challenges that are bound to happen in everyone's life, to live in the full light of wisdom, bliss, and fulfillment. To live life in enlightenment is a natural birthright of every human being. Everyone yearns for the state of completion, a state of eternal contentment, lasting peace, and infinite fulfillment. To quote a sloka from Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, which expresses the innate inclination of every human heart, it says, "Lead me from the unreal to the reality, from darkness to light, from death to immortality." So the desire for enlightenment is planted deep within every soul. The entire ocean of humanity is moving towards higher levels of consciousness, whether we are aware of it or not, because evolution is a natural process of development, from less knowledge to more knowledge, from less power to more power, and from less love to unbounded universal love. As cosmic consciousness is developing, one feels that everything is going by itself. One's desires, which are always evolutionary, are automatically fulfilled without much effort. Whereas previously one used to worry, one does not worry. Life flows smoothly. It is almost as if nothing is happening. Dr. Thangavelu himself is going to explain to you his own experiences in a short period of meditation. All religions echo this truth of the identity between the individual self and the universal self. To quote Christianity, in the Old Testament it is written, man is made in the image of God. The New Testament, we find the words of St. John, I and my Father are one. Quran says, I have only made man to adore me. Tao religion says, to be of heaven is to be in Tao. Tao is forever, and he that possesses it, though his body ceases, he is not destroyed. In love, God is found in the world, and the world is found in God. There are numerous experiences of God consciousness, recorded by saints from different cultures, different religions, different ages, and all of them bear a striking resemblance to each other. They say, the day of my spiritual awakening was the day I saw, and I knew I saw all things in God and God in all things. The growth to enlightenment has been described as a pathless path because being is omnipresent. The journey is from here to here only. In the words of Maharishi Mahesh Yogi, I quote, the state of enlightenment is just the state of utmost relaxation. Enlightenment is waking up from the waking state of consciousness. Gaining enlightenment means simply to be where you are, to be fully the present moment, fully aware, fully awake to who we really are. We are eternal, infinite, immortal, ever free, ever whole, ever one with the entire universe. So enlightenment has been described as an experience of coming back home. We arrive at the source of our being and recognize who we really are. Maybe that's why Sri Ramana Maharshi said, I quote, on the day of liberation, you will laugh. But what is on the day of laughter is also now. Your own realization, self-realization is the greatest service you can render to the whole world, he says. The individual who has gained enlightenment, whether he lives in a cave hidden in the Himalayas or lives in a contemplative science life in a monastery or lives in an active life of service to the world, is a lighthouse spreading a powerful influence of peace and harmony into the entire world and contributing to the upliftment of the human race as a whole. A constant focus towards the unlimited source of love, consciousness, and power creates a more enlightened, empowered, loving state of being in you and me and each one of us. When we have raised our vibration enough, our mind will relax and see the blessing in everything around us. The most important direction we need to turn for answers is inside ourselves. Aham Brahmasmi. The outer world will captivate us and invite us to experience all its tantalizing joys along with the sorrows also. Yet, the most radical and enlightening path of liberation is not one that falls prey to being addicted to the outer world for fulfillment, yet discovers it easily and effortlessly within each one of us. So friends, as long as we continue directing our attention only towards the outer world, wanting this and craving for that, we will be forced to retreat inside ourselves to reboot. Our bodies are designed to remain in a state of balance and healing naturally. Friends, the spiritual enlightened state contains this healing feeling of a sweet surrender and full acceptance to the grand totality of life as a whole. It is in the relaxation into this profound truth that we realize our true infinite spiritual nature and become super powerful magnifying magnets that effortlessly attack anything and everything our heart desires. So when one is spiritually enlightened, there's a constant appreciation for life as it is. The reality of the situation. It does not matter if the ego is getting what it wants or does not want anymore. This feeling is one of the most spiritually enlightening and liberating experiences before. So, dear Master, when we realize that life is always, always, always going to deliver a win-lose experience with every desire we jump after, we start to relax about the whole game and drop into something deeper inside in each one of us ultimately. So the spiritually enlightened being is at peace between both extremes. Getting and not getting, there is also total freedom of choice in each moment as to what is wanted to explore and experience. The spiritually enlightened being realizes there is a chooser behind it all, who can desire to have the experience of avoiding things, clinging to ideas, or simply relax and let the natural movement of life's pendulum guide us along the way this way or that. So the primary purpose of meditation is, without doubt, achieving enlightenment. This is the simplest process, easiest process available to each one of us. Enlightenment has different levels and there are different types. Mindfulness is the beginning of spiritual enlightenment. So make an effort to be mindful and to live in the present moment and all times. That is the path being shown by the breath mindful meditation, Anapanasati, the chosen by Patriji from Vipassana meditation, which is much tougher. Spiritual enlightenment is the highest state a person can achieve. Spiritual enlightenment is the divine moment when you become one with the world. The process of meditation leads to enlightenment, and enlightenment leads to liberation. So, again, to sum up, what we are at the... Oh, Swamiji, yes, yeah.
Yes, Swamiji.
Swamiji, namaskar. That is the path you have shown to all of us. Ultimately, the simplest method you have shown is breath mindful meditation, Anapanasati. I wonder how could you simplify this tough meditation called Vipassana, which Buddha and our Guruji, Goenkaji, learned from Burma and brought it back after 3 months of learning. And ultimately, he brought it down to 10 days, which I underwent. It's a tough course. Of course, that's why, because it's tough, it's gone to 50 countries, but not many are able to do it. 10 days of sitting there, tight morning to night, 2 meals a day, no, total silence. I wonder how could you make it so simple, accessible to everyone, anyone and everyone, only as long as you have the interest and dedication. So that is the greatest contribution of to humanity. Brahmarishi Patriji. Thank you for listening.
I have been hearing you, Swamiji. What a wonderful thing you have been saying. You have been expressing whatever you felt spiritual enlightenment is. You put it in such a wonderful terms, Swamiji. It is great to hear all these things.
It's the only path. There is no other. There are many paths are there, but the simplest path available to each and every. I am not comparing with him. All the paths are great, but you have shown the simplest path which anyone can reach. That's how millions are following it today and experience the benefit. Thank you for that.
Yes, Suresh Babu.
Suresh Babu.
Sir, today is a great day with the spiritual giants and spiritual scientists. They all viewers are listening to your enlightened message. One small question, sir. In the interest of our Freedom Masters and viewers, how and when you met our Patriji sir, and what are your experiences with our great Guruji? Can you please tell us your experiences, sir?
It's a big story, Baba.
Yes.
Who are you asking?
Sir, your experiences with our Guruji, Patriji. Just a brief.
Make it small, only for the first time.
Yeah.
First time I met maybe about 20, 25 years ago, because memory is not good. See, Brahma Rishi Patriji can recall dates and years and places and lengths of people, what happened 40 years back and all that. But first time I met was in Hyderabad. Sai Nigam. When I brought the great spiritual healer, great master from Philippines, you know,
Alex Arbito,
Reverend Alex Arbito, whom I met by chance in Italy, and he's such a simple, humble man. And, you know, it's a long story. I have to make it short. We first meeting itself said, you have to come. You are my chief guest for our spiritual healing festival, global festival in the Pyramid Valley in Portugal. I said, no, but ultimately I had to go there and found how with psychic surgery, power of the mind, he is able to perform surgeries on people and all that. Then we invited him, he came. I took him to Hyderabad. We went on the stage, I saw first time Brahmarshi Patriji there, you know. First time I met him, he came and greeted me with a lot of warmth, embraced me, and as if he has known me for decades or centuries, and said, you're going to connect all the spiritual moments in the world and all that. I did not know his greatness at that time. I thought he's a good soul, a friendly person and all that. So thereafter, we have been meeting. He has been kind enough to call me here and there, Pyramid Valley and all that. Then I found but actually, to be very frank, the real worth, the real value of the form of meditation he has found, the Pyramid Society movement, all that I realized during is only the lockdown period, where we had a lot of time to attend to many of the courses conducted by masters Chandra and Shayans and Newton, and also number of interactions with Patriji and all that. And also the reactions, responses of people who have gone through the meditation. First time, people who have been there for many years, and all that is an amazing experience. And I said, that's why I'm asking, how did you know? How did you visualize this is going to be so powerful, it can transform people? So when he used to tell me yesterday, this is the Dhyana Andhra Pradesh, then Dhyana Bharat, I'm going to make it Dhyana Jagat. I didn't tell him, but I was amused. What is he talking about? How is it going to reach? But now I realize it's going to happen, and it's happening. It's happening. Not only himself has gone around, you know, tireless travel of the master all over the world, all over India, all over Andhra Pradesh and all that. But how many people can he reach? But he has created masters, any number of masters, and had opportunities to listen to many others also. I found all knowledgeable, inspired, dedicated. So Swamiji, you are making it happening. And what, and this is a time people badly need this. One form of immunity is this Dhyana. People are scared, pandemic of fear. Many channels around the world, you know, here, many countries, people are worried about going to be, a lot of suicides are going to happen. People are going to go mad. People are going to suffer depression. Doctors are under treatment and all that, you know. So now I feel that is an essential component of, you know, infusing confidence and leading a life of confidence without fear. An important element is meditation. So I'm contemplating writing my next newsletter, you know, which goes around the world. is medication. Then I said, no, it is going to be better than medication. So I'm going to change the topic. I have not decided on that. Because medication is only to preventing diseases and the healing diseases. But this is far more effective than that. It's larger impact on that. Yes. I think we should listen. People are waiting to listen to Patriji now. I don't want to dominate. Dr. Sangvir is also here, Swamiji. Mr. Guy is here with us, the great publisher.
Yeah.
Yes, I would like to hear him, Swamiji. Guy,
yes, and also Dr. your friend Sangvir is also there from Coimbatore.
Namaskar, Sangvir Swamiji.
Namaskar, Patriji.
Namaskar.
We are, I'm ready to listen to you, sir.
After Tangavadiji.
Swamiji, after a very long time, I have come here to listen to you. What is there to listen to from me? I will talk about medicine, this and that. That is not necessary here.
Yes. Karthikeyanji's next newsletter will be.
Dr. Tangavel is a totally transformed person.
Yes, sir. First of all, we would like to know about the transformation.
Then much I can more than it. Any of us. He is a complete convert, I should say that.
Yes, Tangavel Swamiji.
Swamiji, that thing.
Tangavel, say a few words of what has come to you, what you have become now.
Swamiji, I won't say that some miracle happened, this and that, all those things. I won't say that. But one thing is, I could find some change in me, drastic change in me. My attitude, my approach towards my profession, my administration, my approach towards my administration in the institutions, my approach to the people I am meeting every day, all, you know, I could find a drastic transformation. I feel that I am developing day by day more efficient self-control, and focusing also has improved tremendously. And in the usual emotional outbursts like this anger and using some harsh words, you know, all those things, I can feel that that has come down drastically. So these are all the, I'm only a LKG student, Swamiji. In this LKG student, this is the experience I can share with you. And I think I have to go a long way.
Yes, Swamiji. You have been telling about the effects of Sajjana Sangatya. The last few months of lockdown, you have done a lot of Sajjana Sangatya.
Yes.
You chose to invest your time with the Sajjanas. Adi Shankaracharya said in Bhajya Govindam, Sajjana Sangat Reka Bhavati Bhavarnava Tarane Nauka. Only Sajjana Sangatya, only that will give you, will take you away from the Bhava Sagara, Dukkha Sagara, or the material Sagara, or the Samsara Sagara. So Sajjana Sangatya, you have done a lot of Sajjana Sangatya. It has to be there. That effect has to be there. Sajjana Sangatya paves the way for all the miracles, one after another. Endless miracles. Endless transformations. Each small transformation is called a satori. Each small understanding is called a satori. It's a small enlightenment. So Sajjana Sangatya gives you a chain of satoris, a chain of understandings, a chain of enlightenments, mini enlightenments. Then finally, all these mini, mini enlightenments, they come together, give you a great enlightenment in due course. Sajjana Sangatya gives you the way to dhyana, meditation. It will give you the importance of meditation. As Swamiji said, Karthikeyanji, meditation is the way for enlightenment. But you come to know about meditation only through Sajjana Sangatya. When you are not doing Sajjana Sangatya, you don't know what is meditation. You know only how to make money, name and prestige. But when you come to Sajjana Sangatya, you will come to know, hey, you must do meditation. And you must also read great books, like Bhagavad Gita, like Upanishads, like Swami Rama, Yoganda Paramahamsa. Any number of masters are there. It is only in the Sajjana Sangatya that you know about the requirements of Swadhyaya. So through Sajjana Sangatya, two doors get opened. One is Swadhyaya, another is Dhyana. If you don't do Sajjana Sangatya, then these two doors are not open to you. When do Sajjana Sangatya, when you attended those courses by Chandra and others, then you did a lot of Sajjana Sangatya. You heard everybody's experience. Early morning you used to go there. You used to do meditation and you heard everybody's experiences. That is Sajjana Sangatya. Huge amount of Sajjana Sangatya you did, Swamiji, Sangavediji. I must congratulate you for the choice you made. That Sajjana Sangatya has given you a lot of transformation. Many, many transformations, many, many understandings, many, many satoris, many, many enlightenments. And now you know the whole lifetime you have to spend a lot of time in further Sajjana Sangatya and do meditation and Swadhyaya, read books. When you read so many books, you will get more transformation, Swamiji. Tremendous, Swamiji, to read books. Joe Dispenza, Swami Rama, Yoganda Paramahamsa, so many books are there. Carlos Castaneda, Linda Goodman, Ruth Montgomery, Shirley MacLaine, Jane Roberts, Neil Donald Walsh. So, wonderful things are there in the world of Swadhyaya, and wonderful things are there in the world of Dhyana, meditation. But I must congratulate you, Dr. Sangarveluji. You have entered into the stream. In Buddhism, those people who have entered the stream are called Stotrapanna. That is a technical word in Buddhism. Stotrapanna means you have entered the stream. Once you are not sitting on the edge of the stream. You dive into the stream. You have become Stotrapanna. Now the stream will take you. See, when you are in the stream, that's a key decision made. You jump into the stream. Then what happens? You don't have to do anything else. The stream will take you to the ocean. Into that ocean, already Dr. Karthikeyanji is there.
Swami is there. Swamiji is there.
All Swamijis are there in the ocean. So that river takes you to the ocean automatically by itself.
Beautiful.
It takes a certain amount of time.
Beautifully said.
But you have jumped into the water, Swamiji, Sangavaliji. That is the most key decision.
Now you have no choice.
Now you don't have any choice. The current will take you all the way to the ocean, all the way to Aham Brahmasmi. You exercise your free will, whether to jump or not. And you took the jump. You saw Karthikeyanji jumping, you also jumped.
Swamiji, can see a pyramid behind me?
Yes, sir.
Pyramid, can you see the pyramid?
Oh, yes, sir. I have been seeing that.
This is given by DNN Shastri.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The frame is sent by Chandra, and we got it installed only yesterday. I'm happy to show it to you. It's beautifully done.
Very good, Swami.
Now realizing the value of pyramid also. Yes. Now many people seeing it want, so you are collecting information where all it's available. I think there will be thousands of pyramids around it. More now.
Yes, Swamiji. Yes, Swamiji.
So your Jnan Jagat is happening, Swamiji.
Swamiji, it can't but happen. Satyam eva jayate. That is the motto of government of India.
So the time has come.
Yes, yes. We waited for the time to come in the year 2000. It didn't happen. We waited for the time to come in the year 2012. It didn't happen. Suddenly, once 2019 was over, we came into 2020. This came all over the world. Axis shift. Now, it's like the whole world has entered the stream, Stotrapanna. The whole world will go to the ocean. Everybody will become a Buddha. Everybody will have spiritual enlightenment in the under 10 years. Because the river will take you.
No effort.
Yes. You don't have to swim. When you are in the river and you want to go to the ocean, you don't have to swim. You just have to lie down in the river. Then the river will take you.
Beautiful.
Yes, Swamiji. That turning point comes in everybody's life when you leave the shore and jump into the waters. Sangyabedaji, you have become a Stotrapanna in the language of Buddhism.
Namaskar. You are telling some big words. As you advised me, I read Bhagavad Gita. I am reading for the third time. Every time, you know, some new things I can understand from each chapter. I don't know how many more times I should read this to understand the whole concept.
The whole world has been reading Bhagavad Gita since time immemorial. The whole world, whole mankind has been reading and 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 reading. Every word of Bhagavad Gita is the purest gem. And as you do more meditation, as you do more swadhyaya, as you do more sajjana sangati, you will understand each gem of the Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita has inspired all the people of humanity forever. But unless you do Sajjana Sangatya, unless you do meditation, unless you do other swadhyaya, you cannot understand Bhagavad Gita. The greatness of it. Or the simplicity of it. Simplicity of it. The greatness of it, you cannot understand if you don't do lot of Sajjana Sangatya, lot of Swadhyaya, and lot of Dhyana. Thank you, Sangyavedaji.
I should thank you, Swamiji, and you are so simple, such an enlightened person, traveled all over the world, read more than a lakh of books, and you know, you are so such a simple and such an enlightened person. Now you are my superstar. You are my superstar. And thank you very much for all these opportunities, Swami.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Shreya Babuji.
And guys, have say a few words. Say a few words.
From whom?
To our viewers and to us. To us. Guys, have.
Okay. Guys, have, yes.
Thank you, Rishi.
Yes.
Karthikanji has put me to this road to meditation. And I have been, it has given me a lot of satisfaction and peaceful mind. I'm not getting too many images as yet, but hopefully it will start, because once or twice I had the vision, and but I'm enjoying it, and I'm daily attending Chandraji's morning session from 6 to 7:30. And let me tell you that I never thought that I will be able to do it. But the inspiration has come in, and daily I am up at 4:30 in the morning, and I have a morning walk in my own home, and then at 6 sharp I am there at the Chandraji session, which I am enjoying, learning, and I am looking forward to Patriji's. I have requested him, and he has agreed to give O.P. Ghai Memorial Lecture in the memory of my father on the 1st of October. We are looking forward to it, and hopefully everything will be okay. And I look forward to that. Thank you, Sureshji, Patriji, Karthikanji. You have really put me to this road.
That time has come for you. We are only instruments, you know.
Yes, somebody has to be the instrument.
Yeah.
Without the instrument, machine doesn't work.
Unless I'm convinced about something, I don't lend my name. And when I lend my name, people accept it as truth.
Yes.
And then, like you, many others have come. I was pleasantly surprised to find a deputy chief of mission of the Israeli mission also joining. Normally, diplomats don't like to be identified. I respect it. I respect it. They said, we were there for a lot of talk. So we have said, okay, I told Chandra, we'll start the meditation at 6:15 sharp. So now we are doing it. Amazing. Can you believe it? 6 o'clock, there are already 250 people. That time the meditation started, there are 500, nearly 600 people. And they are there most of till the end. And many from other parts of the world also. That means it has caught on. You know, this is the vision of Premiership Patriji. It's spreading from first to now, only 200 people and 400 people. There are 1,000 people, about 700 people. And some of them each screen is having 2-3 people. About 1,000 people attending morning, early morning sessions. Of all types, you know, of all class of people.
Swamiji. Our master, Mr. Balakrishna, is conducting in Telugu. There are people who have joined, 3,500 people have joined the session.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah.
3,500.
Yes, sir. We are also the participants, sir.
3,500.
Yeah. Early morning, 5 to 7.
5 to 7, amazing.
Yeah, I think wonderful.
Amazing.
Yeah. Channeling by Deepthi Madam and Pavani Madam. It's wonderful sessions going on, sir.
Great.
Yeah.
Swamiji, in that session, masters from other galaxies are coming in and channeling.
Oh.
And some sessions are from night 12 o'clock to morning 4 o'clock. By Premnath Ji.
Right.
Night 12 o'clock to morning 4 o'clock. Where galactic masters are coming and channeling.
Great. Great.
So many things are happening, Swamiji.
Wonderful, Swami. Your vision is happening. But it was becoming a reality. I used to wonder, Oh, Swamiji is talking about Dhyan.
Right now, one session is going on in USA for 55 days, where 500 members are there in USA.
USA.
USA, America.
Very good. Very good.
So everywhere, so many Zoom sessions are going on all over India, Swamiji.
Wonderful.
In the whole of North India, things are happening.
In all languages, happening.
Yes, in all the languages, in Odisha, in West Bengal, in Haryanvi, in Punjab, in Indore, in Nagpur, in Pune, in Mumbai, in Chennai, everywhere.
Swamiji is sitting in one place, participating in everything.
I can't participate in all the things.
Yes.
And right now, in Germany, one program is going on. Since the morning it is going on. I've been attending that in Germany. Right now, today.
Wonderful. Swamiji, it has done a lot of good to you physically. I can see that. I'm happy.
I follow your advice, Swamiji. I'm taking a lot of rest.
I know. I'm so happy this has done a lot of good to you. And being in your own favorite place of sacred pyramid valley. Wonderful.
That's enough. Swamiji, we are all waiting for you here.
I'm coming. People are telling don't travel. I said no. I've given a word to the master. I have to be there. Nothing will stop me from coming there.
We have been receiving some visitors from Siliguri, yes. From other places, Swamiji.
Yes.
Some very selected visitors, very selected.
Wonderful, wonderful. You know, being with you, Swami, and Madam Patriji, there's so much of care and love and all that, blessings. It's a great privilege. I look forward to that. Yes.
Shall we do some meditation, Swamiji? I will sing.
Well, that's a great blessing.
Please close your eyes, hands into hands, fingers into fingers. For 10 minutes, for 15 minutes, let us do meditation. I will sing, I'll play the flute. Music is very good for meditation. Music helps in meditation. Dhyanam seya vendum Dhyanam seidal satyame terindal Dhyaname Dhyanam seidal satyame terindal Vidudalai kidaital adudan perum varam Varangalai perala me Dhyanam seyalame Varangalai peralame Dhyanam seyalame Almave nityam Almave nityam Almave satyam Name Atma Namake Vetri Vetri Vetriye Kidaika Vendum Adarga Dhyanam Seya Vendum Vetriye Kidaika Vendum Adarga Dhyanam Seya Vendum Dhyanam Seidal Jnanam Jnanam Petral Mukhe Dhyanam Onre Seya Vendum Shwasame Sadguru Shwasame Margam Shwasame Pranam श्वास में जीवन जीवन श्वासतिले निलेकवेंडु मनो ध्यानो सेयवेंडु दिनमो dinamo dinamo dhyanam onre seyavendum para abhagarame suya abhagaram para ubhagarame suya ubhagaram ubhagaram seyalame dhyanam कल्पिकलामे उपगारम सेयलामे ज्ञानम कल्पिकलामे श्वास में सद्गुरु श्वास में प्रमार्गम श्वास में प्राणं श्वास में जीवन जीवन श्वासतिले निलेक वेंडु मनो ध्यानम सेय वेंडु ध्यानम सेदल ज्ञानम ज्ञानम पेट्राल मोपे सांस के हो जावे श्वास के सांस के हो जावे मन की शांति तन की स्वस्थता मन की शांति तन की स्वस्थता खुशियों को पाले वे ज्ञानी बन जावे खुशियों को पाले वे ज्ञानी बन जावे सांस को अपनावे देह रथ जानो देही रथिक पहचानो देह रथ जानो देही रथिक पहचानो आत्मज्ञान पाले वे ज्ञानी बन जावे आत्मज्ञान पाले वे ज्ञानी बन जावे जन्म जन्मों के राही जन्मों से छुटकारा जन्म जन्मों के राही जन्मों से छुटकारा आत्मा मोक्ष पाले वे ज्ञानी बन जावे सांस के हो जावे तन मन बाहर दशम द्वार जाहिर तन मन बाहर दशम द्वार जाहिर ब्रह्म कमल खिल जावे ज्ञानी बन जावे ब्रह्म कमल खिल जावे ज्ञानी बन जावे सांस के हो जावे कर्म कर्म में धर्म पल पल में आनंद करम करम में धर्म पल पल में आनंद आनंद ले ले वे ज्ञानी बन जावे आनंद ले ले वे ज्ञानी बन जावे छे कमलों के ऊपर सत्यलोक पहचानो छे कमलों के ऊपर सत्यलोक पहचानो आत्मसत्य पाले वे ज्ञानी बन जावे सब प्राणी सुंदर हम भी सुंदर सब प्राणी सुंदर हम भी सुंदर सुंदरता जी ले वे साधु संत बन जावे सुंदरता जी ले वे साधु संत साधु संत साधु संत बन जावे सांस के हो जावे रे रे मम पब नि नि ज ज रि नि ज ब नि म ब रे म नि नि ब म रि ज नि ज ध्या नि बन जावे म प ब ब म म ब म म ब ब रे रे म रे रे म म ज ज रि ज ज रि रे म म प ब नि नि ब म ब म ब म रे म प म रे म रे ज नि ज ध्या नि बन जावे कृपया कोई भी आंखें न खोलें सांसों के साथ दोस्ती तथा सांसों के साथ मस्ती क्योंकि हमें संत बनना है अगले जन्म में नहीं इसी जन्म में हम किसी से कम नहीं है श्रद्धा हो तो हम कुछ भी बन सकते हैं कहां भी पहुंच सकते हैं व्हाट वी वांट इज सिंसियरिटी एंड सीरियसनेस इन प्रैक्टिस ऑफ मेडिटेशन दीज आर द टू रिक्वायरमेंट्स Sincerity and seriousness. In practice of meditation, anapanasati, being with the breath. Another 10 minutes. Don't open your eyes. Be with your normal, natural breath. Remember that we have always been gods. We are gods and we are gods forever. We have come to have an experience in this physical body, that's all. A blissful experience, not a horrible experience. We are gods come to have human experiences, wonderful human experiences. For that you need to be with your breath. You need to be a meditator, you need to be a yogi. To understand life on this human plane, in this earth planet. Otherwise, you will come and go without having any blissful experiences. We are all gods, come to have nice human experiences on this earth planet. In a very nice human body, we have come. Final 10 minutes, be with your breath. Normal, natural breath. Don't open your eyes. That is the only requirement. Never ever open the eyes. Once you open your eyes, you lose a lot of tons and tons of energy to catch the world outside. You need to keep that energy within yourself to be able to go to the source of the truth, core of the truth, which is what you are. Be with your breath, be with your normal, natural, easy, soft, simple, tender, peaceful, tranquil breath. That's all you need to do. Never ever open your eyes. Final 5 minutes. Be with your breath. Never ever open your eyes. Establish emptiness in the mind. No thoughts whatsoever in the mind. Become one with the pure breath. Only 5 minutes more. Be with your breath. Be with your normal, natural, easy, soft, simple, tender, peaceful, tranquil breath, my dear gods. Aham Brahmasmi Tattvamasi. That is the truth. We are temporarily living in these physical bodies. to have a physical experience. We chose. That's why we are here. We all wanted very nice human experience. That's why we are here in the human bodies. We came here by our own choice, our own planning. Let us accept our choices. Let us accept our plannings. Let us execute them perfectly. Our own choice. We chose our own parents. We chose our own body, male or female. We chose our own circumstances. We chose our own targets. We chose our own adventures. Tomorrow or after, we are leaving the body. That is for sure. The journey will end. Let us make this journey very, very happy journey. Let us become highly contented selves. Another 3 minutes, don't open your eyes. Be with your normal, natural breath. Final 1 minute. आखिरी 30 सेकंड, कृपया कोई भी आंखें न खोले। उच्छ्वास निश्वास के साथ एक होकर रहेंगे। सांसों के पुत्र बनेंगे, पवन पुत्र बनेंगे, बजरंग बली बनेंगे। हम किसी से कम नहीं है। पल पल कीमती है, हम इसका सदुपयोग करेंगे। पल पल का हम भी कबीर जी के जैसे बनेंगे, हम भी संत ज्ञानेश्वर जी के जैसे बनेंगे, हम भी गौतम बुद्ध के जैसे बनेंगे, हम भी तिरुवल्लुवर जी के जैसे बनेंगे। हम क्यों नहीं बनेंगे? हम किसी से कम नहीं है। बस सांसों के पुत्र बने, पवन पुत्र बने, यही है श्री रामायण जी का निचोड़। श्री रामायण जी का रहस्य, गूढ़ रहस्य, पवन पुत्र बनो, श्वास के पुत्र बनो, आनापान सती करो बाबा। जब जब आप दुनिया की दुविधा में गिरते हैं, आप ध्यान की सुविधा में आ जाइए। हमेशा दुनिया दुविधा में गिरा देती सभी लोगों को, बट सुविधा है अपने पास ही है, अनापानुसति की सुविधा। आखिरी 10 सेकंड, नौ, आठ, सात, छः, पांच, चार, तीन, दो, एक, शून्य। काइंडली कीप योर हैंड्स ऑन योर आईज फॉर 5 सेकंड्स। 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0। स्लोली रिमूव योर हैंड्स एंड यू मे ओपन योर आईज माय डियर फ्रेंड्स एंड माय डियर गॉड्स। Thank you very much, Swamiji. Who is organizing this?
Yeah, sir, on behalf of Digital Dhyana Swajaya Yoga, we are very much grateful and we are conveying our sincere thanks to Katkeenji for having come here and spent almost 2 hours time with us. He gave an enlightened message on spirituality, soul science and enlightenment. We are very, very grateful and thank you very much, sir. And pranams to our Guruji for having given such a simple and lifetime concept of those who one jumps into the stream of meditation, Sajjan Sangachya and Swajhyaya. The stream will naturally take you to the ocean. It's a very, very wonderful concept to reach enlightenment. And our sincere thanks to Dr. Tangwari sir and Dr. Kai sir for participating in this Zoom session. We are all grateful and thank you very much, sir. Once again, thank you, sir.
Rumba Rumba Nandri Swamiji, Kartikeyan ji.
Thank you, Swami.
Thank you, Veluji. Ghai sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sai.
I have to go to Germany now.
Oh, okay. Bon voyage, Swamiji.
Zoom session is there in Germany after 9 o'clock.
Wonderful. You are such all over the world, sitting in one place, beautiful. Yeah.
Thank you, Anuradha.
Sir,
सभी लोगों को बताइए क्या
मेरे बारे में. सर मैं बोली हूँ सर, मैं लास्ट 14 इयर्स से मैं आई टोल्ड यू ना सर, आई हैव बीन इन द पीएसएसएम फॉर द पास्ट 14 इयर्स.
नो, फॉर द सेक ऑफ ऑल द अदर मास्टर्स.
घबराहट
होती है सर, इंग्लिश उतना फ्लुएंसी आती कि नहीं आती है इंग्लिश, फिर भी मैं
हिंदी में बोलिए.
ओके सर, मैं मेरा नाम अनुराधा है, मैं प्रॉपर कर्नाटक की हूँ, लेकिन लास्ट 12 इयर्स से मैं हैदराबाद में सेटल्ड हूँ. 2007 में हम लोग जब तिरुपति जा रहे थे तो उधर जो टैक्सी ड्राइवर था ना, वो ड्राइवर ने हमको ध्यान के बारे में बताया था कि आप सांस के ऊपर लक्ष्य रखना है और अगर सोच आए तो उसको सोच को काटना है और जितना एज है आपका उतना मिनट बैठना है करके हमको टैक्सी ड्राइवर ने बोला था. तो उसके हिसाब से हम लोग क्या किया कि हम लोग इतना आश्चर्य हो गए कि वो डॉक्टर ने ड्राइवर ने कहा कि आप घर में बैठ के ही भगवान का दर्शन कर सकते हो. तो मैंने सोचे कि हम लोग सोचे कि घर में बैठ के भगवान का दर्शन कैसा हो सकता है. तो फिर हम लोगों ने सोचा कि हम लोगों ने कि चलो हम लोग भी ये प्रैक्टिस करेंगे कि ये ध्यान का प्रैक्टिस करेंगे हम लोग करके हम डिसाइड करें. तो उसके बाद क्या हो गया कि टैक्सी ड्राइवर ने ये कहा कि वो बिफोर मेडिटेशन ही वॉज ए नॉन वेजिटेरियन, वो नॉन वेजिटेरियन था, आफ्टर मेडिटेशन ही बिकम अ वेजिटेरियन हो गया. फिर बाद में क्या हुआ कि उसका फाइनेंशियल प्रॉब्लम था वो सॉल्व हो गया, बच्चे अच्छे सेटल्ड हो गया, लाइफ हैप्पीली बिता रहा था. कौन वो टैक्सी ड्राइवर, अपना अनुभव हमसे शेयर किया. तो हम लोगों ने इतना वंडर हुआ कि ध्यान करने से इतना कुछ लाभ है, वो भी सांस के ऊपर ऑब्जर्विंग अवर ब्रेथ वी विल गेन दिस मच ऑफ व्हाट बेनिफिट्स, ऐसा मैंने सोचा. तो हम लोग, मैं उस वक्त सर मैंने कहा था ना सर आपको कि मैं उस वक्त स्टूडेंट थी, इंजीनियरिंग थर्ड ईयर में थी मैं, बेंगलुरु में थे हम लोग, पेइंग गेस्ट में रहते थे. तो मैंने सीधा क्या किया, नेट में चले गए मैं और मेरे सिस्टर, PSSM www.pssm.org.com एक वेबसाइट था उस वक्त, अभी भी है। तो उस वेबसाइट में मैंने टाइप मारा, तो मैंने पूछा कि मेरा नियर नज़दीक का सेंटर कौन सा है। तो उधर राजा जी नगर फोर्थ ब्लॉक में संध्या मैडम करके बेंगलुरु में सेंटर चलाती है सर, तो हमको सेंटर का एड्रेस मिला। तो उसी दिन क्या किया हम लोगों ने, शाम को 6 बजे 2007 में मैं और मेरा रूममेट्स और मेरा बहन, चार गर्ल्स गए सेंटर का, जाके बैठ गए ध्यान में। तो वो मैडम इतना हैप्पी हो गई सर कि हम लोग घर घर बोले तो भी ध्यान को नहीं आते, ये लोग क्या इतना दूर से खुद आए हैं कि हमको ध्यान में बिठाओ। तो हम, मैं और मेरा सिस्टर, सब लोग ध्यान में बैठे। मैंने जैसे ही 6 बजे गई थी सर, मैं जब से ही मैंने आंखें ओपन किया तो मैंने देखा कि 8:40 ऐसा बज गया था, मीन्स ऑलमोस्ट 2.5 आवर में बैठी थी। मेरे रूममेट्स गायब थे, मेरा बहन भी गायब थी, मैं एक ही बच गई थी। तो मुझे वो मैडम आके कहा कि उठो अनुराधा, अब आपका टाइम हुआ, घर जा सकते हो। फिर उसने ये बात बोला कि आपको और भी इसका बेनिफिट लेना है, तो क्या आपको 41 डेज ध्यान करना है। तो मैंने कहा कि 41 डेज चलो ठीक है, करेंगे, देखेंगे आखिर ये क्या है। तो मैं रेगुलर सर, मेरा प्रोजेक्ट वर्क था, मैं थर्ड ईयर में थी, मेरा प्रोजेक्ट वर्क जैसे ही खत्म होता था मैं सीधा जाती थी सेंटर में, आंखें बंद करना बैठना, अमावस्या ध्यान करती थी, मूनलाइट पौर्णमी ध्यान करती थी और डेली सत्संग अटेंड करती थी। मैं स्टूडेंट थी कि मैं कभी भी डुमा नहीं मारा 41 डेज। वैसे ही मेरा ध्यान का अनुभव बढ़ता चले गया, बढ़ता मैं ध्यान का इन्वॉल्व हो गई। तो उसमें मुझे क्या हो गया कि मुझे ये लगा कि जो आनंद है, जो आनंद, हैप्पीनेस, सेटिस्फैक्शन, यस मैंने कुछ किया, वो सब क्या है कि हमारे अंदर ही है, लेकिन हम क्या कर रहे हैं वो उसको बाहर खोज रहे हैं, कि दोस्तों से बातें करने से या पिक्चर देखने से, सिनेमा देखने से, सिनेमा करने से, गप्पा मारने से हमको ये आनंद मिल रहा करके हम सोच रहे हैं, लेकिन असल ऐसा है ही नहीं है। आनंद तो हमारे अंदर ऑलरेडी हमारा भीतर छुपे हुए हैं, लेकिन हमको मालूम नहीं है। वो मालूम कराता है, वही है ध्यान। ध्यान हमको सिखाता है कि तुम ये ओरिजिनल हो, तुम्हारे अंदर ही सब कुछ है, तुम बाहर मत भागो, अपने अंदर का जो चीजें हैं उसको देखो, उसको एक्सपीरियंस करो। तो मुझे वो ट्रुथ जैसे ही मालूम हुआ सर, मैं 2007 से लगातार मैडम के साथ प्रचार कर रही थी बेंगलुरु में हॉस्टल वगैरह में। तो उस वक्त मेरे को सार पत्री सर आए थे उस दिन 2007 में, 8 में शायद संध्या मैडम सेंटर आए थे सर, रात के खाने के लिए आए थे। तो मेरे ना उस वक्त मैं सोचा कि हमारे घर में जो है वही बोल रहे हैं, हमारे घर में बहुत नाराज थे पेरेंट्स, वो लोग सोच रहे थे कि ये स्टडी डिसकंटिन्यू करेगी क्या, ध्यान करेगी, ध्यान प्रचार बोल रही है करके सोच रहे थे। तो बाद में मैंने लास्ट एक बार सर को एक बार मिलेंगे करके मैं सेंटर करने गई, तो मुझे सर ने ऐसा बोल दिया कि मेरा पर्पज ऑफ लाइफ क्या है, मैं क्या करने आई हूँ, ये सब मुझे एक ही वर्ड में बोल दिया, मेरे को माइंड में बैठ गया बस। ऑलरेडी मैं 6 महीने प्रचार कर चुकी थी, तो मेरे को ना अभी प्रचार करना मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगता है, वेजिटेरियन रैली करना मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगता है, पिरामिड्स कंस्ट्रक्ट करने के लिए दूसरों को मोटिवेट करना मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगता है। मैं यही काम करती हूँ सर, मैं एक हाउसवाइफ हूँ, मुझे 2 बच्चे हैं, मेरा हस्बैंड जो है पिरामिड मास्टर ही है, वो गुंटूर के हैं आंध्र प्रदेश, और मैं कर्नाटक की हूँ, आंध्रा और कर्नाटक का मैरिज है ये, और मेरे हस्बैंड का फुल सपोर्ट है। मैं ध्यान करती हूँ, ध्यान प्रचार ज़्यादा करती हूँ, और मैं सोचती हूँ कि जो भी ध्यान को अपनाएगा, जो भी हमारा इस PSSM में आएगा ना, वो हाईएस्ट मास्टर हाईएस्ट है सर, क्योंकि इसके बाद कुछ सीखने का नहीं है, यही लास्ट है, इससे बढ़कर आपको कोई मिलेगा ही नहीं है। जस्ट आंखें बंद करना है, हमारे माइंड को, दिमाग को खाली करना है और हमारे अंदर जाना है कि ओरिजिनल मैं क्या हूँ, कि मेरा अंदर ही है ये सब कुछ, आनंद हो, सेटिस्फेक्शन हो, जो भी भाव हो वो मैं ही हूँ, वो सब एक्सपीरियंस इस ध्यान में होता है, मुझे उसी में ही तृप्ति है। और मैं बहुत बहुत मेरा सार से, गुरुजी से, ब्रह्मर्षि पितामह पत्री जी से मैं बहुत आभारी हूँ, मुझे बहुत चेंज हो गया, मेरा लाइफ कम्प्लीटली चेंज हो गया। हम जो थॉट पावर क्या है, संकल्प बोले तो क्या है, हम जो संकल्प करते होते हैं, मैं सोचा था सर इस लॉकडाउन में, मुझे नहीं मालूम था, 1 ईयर बैक मैं सोच रही थी कि मैं नॉर्थ इंडिया प्रचार करने नहीं जा रही हूँ, मैं फॉरेन में प्रचार करने नहीं जा रही हूँ, मुझे बच्चे हैं, मैं नहीं जा रही हूँ करके वो दुख था। लेकिन इस लॉकडाउन में देखिए सर, मैं इंटरनेशनल लेवल में भी क्लास ले रही हूँ, सभी नॉर्थ इंडियन मास्टर्स के साथ क्लास ले रही हूँ, पूरा ग्लोब में मैं जुड़ चुकी हूँ, सबको मैं इतना परिचय हूँ कि अनुराधा कौन है, कौन सा मास्टर है, ये क्या काम करती है करके, ऐसा मुझे इतना ध्यान प्रचार मिलने को ये अवकाश हुआ है लॉकडाउन से सर। जो वो संकल्प था मेरे को, मन में था कि मुझे ऑल ओवर ग्लोब जाना है, प्रचार करना है, तो ये घर पर बैठे बैठे मुझे एक अवकाश मिल गया कि जूम के माध्यम से मैं सबसे जुड़ी हूँ और हर जगह मैं सबको ध्यान सिखा रही हूँ, अभी इन दिनों में थोड़ा शेयर होल्डर्स का भी घूम रही हूँ, दिन भर घूमती हूँ, 4 बजे से घर रहती हूँ, फिर बैठ। तो थैंक यू सर, मैं आपको यही की रिक्वेस्ट करती हूँ कि आप सब लोग ध्यान कीजिए और ध्यान प्रचार कीजिए। थैंक यू वेरी मच।
वेरी गुड।
कार्तिकेय जी, मेरे साथ रेणु मुखर्जी है, रेणु अग्रवाल, ये सिलीगुड़ी से आई है, सिलीगुड़ी से। आपके दो अनुभव बताइए।
दोनों कर्मा,
हाँ बताओ फटाफट। स्वामी जी सुन रहे।
नमस्ते, मैं सिलीगुड़ी से। नमस्ते सर, मैं सिलीगुड़ी से रेणु अग्रवाल। सर मैं आपके साथ मेरे दो अनुभव शेयर करूंगी। मैंने अपना पास्ट लाइफ का अनुभव, जो इस लाइफ के साथ जो मेरा लिंक है, कि कैसे पास्ट कर्मास हमें इस लाइफ में किस तरह से मतलब कैसे क्रिएट हम करते हैं और किस तरह से वो काम करता है, तो उसके बारे में मैं आपसे शेयर कर रही हूँ। तो सर अभी कुछ दिन पहले मैंने मतलब मेरा जो बेटा है, बड़ा वाला बेटा, आप सबको हिंदी समझ में आती है यहाँ पे? जो मेरा बड़ा वाला जो बेटा है उसको एडवेंचर ज्यादा पसंद है सर। तो वो 27 इयर्स का हो गया, तो हमें तो यही रहता है ना सर कि जब बच्चे जब बड़े हो जाते हैं तो या तो वो जॉब करेंगे या फिर वो बिजनेस करेंगे हमारा, और फिर शादी करेंगे, बस हम इतना ही सोचते हैं, उससे आगे हमारी सोचने की और कोई कैपेसिटी है नहीं। अगर बच्चे अगर बिजनेस करते या जॉब करते हैं और शादी करते हैं तो हम बहुत, माँ बाप भी परेशान हो जाते हैं, माँ बाप से ज्यादा परेशान हो जाते हैं आसपास के लोग, सोसाइटी के लोग ज्यादा परेशान हो जाते हैं। तब अब बच्चे जब बड़े हो जाते हैं तो सब पूछने लग गए, क्या आप अपने बेटे की कब शादी करोगे, कब शादी करोगे। वो शादी के लिए हाई नहीं भरता है, वो मुझे एक ही बात बोलता है कि आपने शादी करके क्या पा लिया, मुझे आप ये बताओ। तब फिर उसके बाद मैं आपको बताऊं मतलब, और शादी करना और दो बच्चा पैदा करना, क्या यही हमारी लाइफ है, इसी के लिए हम पैदा हुए हैं। तो मेरे पास कुछ शब्द नहीं थे और बोलने के लिए, तो मैं बोली ठीक है बेटा ओके, आप अगर जो भी आप करना चाहते हो आप बताओ, आपको नहीं करना है आप मत करो। फिर उसके बाद उसकी MBA हम करवाए, इतने अच्छे कॉलेज से वो पढ़ के आया। उसके बाद देखते हैं कि कोई भी काम की रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज वो लेना नहीं चाहता है, उसको खाली क्या है, घूमना, कभी बाइक लेके घूमना तो कभी साइकिल लेके घूमना तो कभी गाड़ी लेके घूमना, बस कल उसको एडवेंचर पसंद है। और सबसे बड़ा बेटा तो या तो ये अगर वो बाप का बिजनेस नहीं संभालेगा या वो जॉब नहीं करेगा तो कैसे होगा, तो इस चीज को लेकर हमारे टेंशन रहता था और इस चीज को लेकर हम परेशान भी रहते थे। तो उसका जो नेचर था वो हम एक्सेप्ट नहीं कर पा रहे थे, वो जैसा भी था उसका नेचर हमसे एक्सेप्ट नहीं हो पा रहा था। तब फिर लास्ट में मतलब जैसे ऐसे सोचे भाई चलो ठीक है, चुप रहने में ही भलाई है, आजकल अगर ज्यादा अगर बोलेंगे तो फिर बच्चे भी जवाब देते हैं, तो इससे अच्छा मत ही बोलो, वो जैसे चाह रहा है वैसे ही ठीक है। वो बोलता है ये बिजनेस नहीं करना है, ये करना है, ठीक है ओके भाई तुम ये कर लो, एक दिन करता है फिर पीछे आ जाता है, नहीं मेरे को नहीं करना, फिर एक बिजनेस करता है फिर पीछे आ जाता है, नहीं मेरे को नहीं करना। एक्चुअल में उसको उसमें बंधना ही नहीं है, उसको ये डर है कि अगर ये बिजनेस अगर करता हूं तो मैं बंध जाऊंगा। उसको फ्रीडम चाहिए, उसको घूमना है पूरी जगह, एडवेंचर चाहिए। तो लास्ट में फिर उसके बाद अभी थोड़े दिन पहले वो अपने पापा को बोल रहा है मेरे को साइकिल लेके पौंडीचेरी मेरे को जाना है। तब फिर उसके बाद जैसे उसके बाद इसके पापा ने मुझे बताया, तब फिर मैं थोड़ी सी परेशान हो गई कि ऐसा कैसे ये साइकिल लेके पौंडीचेरी जाएगा, मतलब हमारे सिलीगुड़ी से लेके पौंडीचेरी तक का हो गया 2500 किलोमीटर, साइकिल में जाएगा तो मतलब 3 महीने लग जाएंगे। तब फिर इस तरह से मेरा मतलब बहुत परेशानी रही। फिर मैंने ध्यान भी किया, उसमें भी आंसर पाने की कोशिश की कि ऐसा क्यों हो रहा है। तो इन शॉर्ट में मैं आपको बताती हूँ फिर हुआ क्या, ये कर्मा कैसे मुझे पता चला। तब फिर जब मैं ध्यान कर रही थी तो ध्यान में मुझे पता चला कि जैसे ये किसी राजा के वहाँ पे एक काल कोठरी में बंद था, जब ये काल कोठरी में बंद था तो ये दुनिया नहीं देखा, ये दुनिया जब नहीं देखा तो इसको था कि मुझे दुनिया घूमना है, मुझे पूरा दुनिया देखना है, मैंने दुनिया देखी नहीं। तो ये एक उसके मन में तड़प थी, पेन था, और मैं बगल वाली काल कोठरी में थी, तो तब मैंने उससे प्रॉमिस किया, मैंने उसका पेन को समझा और उससे मैंने प्रॉमिस किया कि नेक्स्ट जन्म जब तुम लोगे तो मैं तुमको ये दुनिया दिखाऊंगी, तो तुम इस दुनिया में इस बार मेरे कोख से आना। तब इसीलिए फिर उसने मुझे चूज किया अपने मम्मी के हिसाब से, और वो मेरे पे ट्रस्ट करके इस दुनिया में आया। उसको वो घूमने के लिए ही आया है, वो इन बंधनों में बंधने के लिए नहीं आया है। तब मैंने इस चीज को समझ कर मैंने एक्सेप्ट किया। तो ये मेरा
थैंक यू
सुरेश बाबू,
बहुत अच्छा अनुभव सुनाया है मैडम ने, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद कार्तिकेयन जी, और एक बार धन्यवाद आपको गुरु जी, आपका प्रणाम, और एक बार थैंक्स टू ऑल पार्टिसिपेंट्स, थैंक यू
थैंक यू सो मच सर, कार्तिकेयन सर फॉर कमिंग हियर,
थैंक यू, बाय,
यस सर, थैंक यू सर।